still a lot of the company used the old-fashioned, the embedded approach also. Then, the Informix has their own compiler. DB2 provide their own compiler. Most of the very popular DBMS vendor provide most of the language pre-compiler. But if you are using the some very limited or the open source, sometimes it's limited. Okay, that is one of the reasons why the company, the big company, they try to use the, even though that is expensive, so they want to use such a thing. Okay, that is a two-step compiler. After you compile that, you can do this one. Finally, you have the C application. Then, once you run the, this one, then and part of this, connect the database, getting the data. So to do that, there should be common variable inside. Okay, detailed, I will show you the slide, but nowadays I do not have exercise left for proceed, but if you want to do that, you can use the Oracle, our own database, and Visual C++. You can use the C++, then a lot of setup you can find from internet or Oracle reference. Then you need to set up a lot of things, then finally you can do that. Okay, but nowadays I give up to have the practice in the exercise lab, but if you want, you can practice to connect the database using the C and or C++ to using the embedded approach. To do that, you need to have the common variable. Output of the name should be stored at the host language, C language, the variable. Then you can process it. That's the key point when you are doing such an embedded approach. That is the first approach. Second approach is, was very popular when I learned the database the first time. Okay, then people realized that when you are using the such an embedded approach, it's a two-step. One is pre-compiler. Pre-compiler convert the embedded part, SQL part, into the host language. Anyway, that is a C language. So who provide such an embedded part? SQL part into the C. It's a pre-compiler. DBMS has the ability to convert this one. Can I use this SQL? Then I don't have to worry about the SQL. Right? Anyway, this part will be converted to this one. Okay? So some of DBMS, some, not all of them, some of DBMS provide API. API level core interface. Which means, actually it is, as I mentioned before, it is true when, for example, Oracle developed their own Oracle DBMS machine, okay, system, they use C language, 80%. Can I use that C language directly? If you can do that, we don't have to worry about the SQL, right? So that is the core interface. It's the API approach. We can directly use this kind of database system API. Okay? That's the database system library we can use. So for example, Oracle has the OCI, Oracle Core Level Interface. It's a very, very low level program. If you see the API name, it's sometimes ABC like this. It's a very low level. So almost impossible to understand. However, good thing is performance 3 or 4 times faster. One, it doesn't need the SQL-like the language compilation. Okay, lexical analysis or the parsing, we don't need. Just the directory. It's the most kind of assembly programming. Okay, if we consider the operating system, it's kind of assembly level the programming. But the good news is it's very, very fast. So very, very limitedly we use this one. I did 2 or 3 times to download and upload the data in Oracle. But some of the DBMS, they do not release, open their core level interface. But the other, like the Oracle provide, is API level programming. But there are not much reference, and also is the, even if you call the Oracle support, the customer support, even the, their the technical support, they do not know. It's a kind of their secret inside. They try to hide so such a level. But if you, you can find a job, the posting, who that they are, who are looking for the OCI, the program, the expertise. So if you know that this one, it's a, it easily, I guess, I can guarantee it's 200,000, more than 200,000 salary you can get. So this is just, keep in mind, just the name of that is OCI level, API level interface. Nowadays, the more popular, so it's difficult to learn. Even though I used a couple of times, this one, by copy and paste the template and change it some, even I do not know, figure out which part is the selection, which part is the projection, it's very hard. But third one is nowadays the most popular one. It's very complicated to do the two programming and the embedded or the OCI. What if we consider from the programming, especially nowadays the object-oriented programming. Object-oriented programming. So why don't we consider database access as a part of object? Okay? So we can create the object for connect. We can create the object for select, okay? For example, Java object. Then we can just put the table name or condition or the update object. We can create object by object, library. So this is called, the third one is library or component based. So which means we consider the database access, SQL part as a part of the programming, as a component or library. Benefit? We don't have to worry about the details of connection or whatever, just call this one, this one, this one, whenever we need. Problem? It's not much flexible. We cannot use the full functionality of the SQL. Instead, we need to use the, only the, this library. For example, JDBC, Java, database, connectivity. Who make the, this one?
Java.
Java group. Nowadays, it's a part of Oracle, but anyway, the Java. When the, that is a part of some microsystem, then the, they, Java group, what is the motto of the slogan of the Java? Compile once, run everywhere, kind of standardized. So, database is, even though they are standardized based on the SQL 2 or SQL 3, each of them has their own the functionality. Some of them are not standardized. So, can we make the standardized database connection? So Java designed the standardized using their the library, Java API. So they create the Java API to connect the data. So for example, when you connect the data, you need JDBC and specify host name, port name, and database instance, database name, username, password. As long as you provide this information, you can connect any database. It's a standardized. So, then at the time, how can you use the, this one? You can use Java API. It's a, this library. So make the, this. So each program language make the, such a thing, so you can easily use that. So most of ASP.NET and the, for example, the ODBC, Microsoft standardized database connection using the ODBC. Then you can consider database connection as the object component. Okay, and it's advanced to the ADO, advanced database object. So you can consider database part as the part of your program language. Benefit that because of that. it looks like the database connection is not the tool level, it's a part of a program language. However, inside it's not. It's just a pretend for the database connection. So because of that, to use the ODBC or ADO, you need to set up everything before you start. Also, I heard that from my colleague who worked for the company, what he's doing is he developed the package to access the data. Inside, the database connection part is the hidden inside the component. So to change the code, it will be very hard to find which library has the database connection. It looks like there is no database, but inside the code, they have the database connection as a part of the component and or as a part of the library. So there are three different ways. First one is embedded approach. Okay, so we can make the something group of SQL part and that needs a precompiler. Second part is API or code level interface. It's a low level program language provided by the DBMS we can use. It's rarely used, but nowadays it's mostly library or the component based like the JDBC or the ADO.NET and ADO. So we can see the example. So in your exercise that you will practice ASP.NET example with the GA. But I'd like to leave the any question?
So Professor, all three approaches are three-tier approach, right?
It doesn't matter. It can be two-tier. That is what is the main difference between the two-tier and three-tier?
The middleware.
It's a middleware. So what is the main purpose of the middleware? Is the interface? No. It's a transaction control. So if there are a lot of the client requests, so server cannot handle all of them. Instead, we need to put something in the middle, like a transaction manager or TP monitor. Nowadays, web service, webs, up long time ago, the web service is just server-side programming. If there is a request and response. But nowadays, web server include application server. Application server is acting as role as such a monitor. So that is a three tier. So we can use this database programming technique both two tier and three tier also. Yes.
Do we need in the third approach? Mm-hmm. We still need a compiler.
Oh yes, you need a compiler. So but these are already pre-compiled as a library or a component, right?
Then you can from JDBC will have its own.
Yeah, you need to follow that the API document. That is a little bit the limitation. If you want a flexibility, sometimes you need to change the code of API level. But pretty much enough nowadays is getting the stronger and the powerful. The API. So goal is if we forget about the database connection part, that's the best way. But in our classroom, you need to understand such a mechanism. In case there's something problem, you should be able to understand where is the problem, whether this is a database problem, whether it's a program level problem, or it's a configuration problem, then you can solve that problem. Okay, so we talk about the two parts always, the host language and database language. For the database language, it's a SQL only. And the host language, we can use not any, okay? Most of the program languages provide the database part, okay? There are different approach. One is embedded. I do not mention about this one. I will explain the later, okay? The embedded SQL, so that is the API level, embedded SQL, API level is a core level interface, and the last one is such a library. I will explain the PI SQL later. So embedded SQL, like this is the example of the C, proceed. So this is the after you, if this is the embedded part, for example, EX is the SQL, delete, whatever, this will, if you pre-compile this one, it will be like this. It will be changed as the C code, okay? And the API is very hard to understand, okay? There, but if you are able to use this the core level interface, API level programming, it will be performance is four times faster. Because no housekeeping job here, no other the overhead, just focusing on to access the data. And then the component trip. The library based, like the, for example, Microsoft provide ODBC, or nowadays is advanced database or data object. We will consider such a connection and the database part as an object. Okay, then in the programming, so we can easily use such an object. Java provide the JDBC. JDBC, so if we, that is the reason the. If you want to use the JDBC, you need to download the driver, JDBC driver. What is the JDBC driver? That is the library that already compiled by the Java group. Okay, then they provide this library. If you want to use the Oracle database, you need to download this JDBC driver. It's API. Then if you want to connect, follow this syntax. Okay. Then if you want to select the data, follow this syntax. If you get the data, follow this syntax. There are something like that. That is the driver. That is nothing but the bunch of classifier. Okay. This slide shows such a, based on the platform, the performance, or what kind of language you support, so you can consider. Always, whenever we use the database programming, connect the database. One, because it's a programming language, database has their own authentication. So you need to pass through, you need to get through the such authentication that require connection. Then you can do something and close, terminate. So embedded SQL, I already explained, like this, the SQL block. This is called the SQL block. EX is a SQL begin, EX is a SQL end. Inside, this is the database, the language. I think that this part is a declare section. Declare section means we need to have the common variable between host language and database language. This will be defined here. So for example here, the loop one and while loop, this is a host language, C language. But if you want to use the SQL, then you can see the semicolon. Semicolon means it's actually host language variable, but will be used inside the SQL block. Then the output of this one will be stored at here in the memory side. In the our computing architecture memory side, then we are able to access the return the data. Problem. In the database, we consider data as a group. In the programming language, data by data. So what about this one? When you run this code, it will return
data by data.
Group of data. Because it's a database query, it will return the data as a group. So in the programming side, programming cannot handle, host language cannot handle such a group of data altogether. Instead, because of that, database provides kind of it's a buffer, okay? Temporary room, which is called the cursor, C-U-R-S-O-R, cursor. It's a kind of a temporary room in the memory. So when you run the Discord, group of data will be stored there. It's kind of poor, all the data in the temporary room. Then from your host language, you can fetch one by one. Fetch one by one. That is the main difference when you are doing the database programming. That is the cursor and the fetch. So cursor is kind of temporary room to keep the return data. Using the SQL. Then from the root, then the host language can fetch one by one. Okay? So that is a reason cursor sometimes is very important. how many cursor you are going to define in your memory, in your system. So the more the better, but it's a waste of your memory. If you have less, your system will be slow. So it is a cursor. This is another, this is a technique, okay? This is not the approach of the database programming, but it's kind of a technique. For example, I'd like to select the name and address. Name and address of the professor. Professor. My professor name and address. Name and phone number. So I build a web interface like this one. This is a web interface. So if I click the button info, this one will call the SQL part that can select the name and phone number from the professor where the last name is Lee. Because my professor is always Lee in this semester. So I can click and this part will be executed and written. If you are using the this menu, it's the same query. If we are using the this menu, it's the same query. This query will not be changed. This is called the SETI SQL. However, this is implemented general purpose. If you type the last name, Lee, and button, okay? So sometimes Lee is okay. However, if this one is the Smith, you need to lock different query, right? Select name and change this one to name. How many professor? 100 professor. You need to implement 100 of the SQL. If there's a new professor, you need to add new SQL. It's not convenient, right? Instead of the static SQL is a very, very minimal. So only fix the SQL only. Then, like the system date, if you select the current date, it's always the same. Select the date. But if you have the, such a variable, so this will be changed as the variable. So at that time, instead of the static SQL, you can, based on the menu, you can make in your, if, so this is a, let's say A, the LN. If LN is not null, okay, then SQL, let's say this is a SQL text string. SQL text is blah, 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 and plus one. The last name is the input, this one, LN. You can assemble the SQL. This one can be extended like a several menu. This is a name, this is the ID, this is a major, three input value, and submit the button. Sometimes you can have the value, 111, sometimes it's a null, and submit the value. By checking whether if, then else if, then you can make the, assemble the SQL text, okay? Then we don't have to create a number of the query. Instead, one, this is called dynamic SQL. So dynamic SQL is very popular based on such a input value. Okay? Then submit the button. So in your the project, you can definitely consider such a dynamic SQL. Probably you started from the, such a static SQL, but it can be easily the migrate, you can change it, the such a static SQL into the dynamic SQL. Okay. So dynamic SQL is your query will be the different during the runtime. So how can we do that? We can assemble. We can make the SQL statement based on the input or condition. Okay. So for example, in the this is an example of the dynamic SQL in the using the embedded approach. So we can define the SQL updated string. So it's a SQL text, SQL statement variable. Then, depending on the input value, we can assemble different way. Okay. This can be easily applied to the any database programming language, okay. The Java and the other also. Okay. Next one is the stored procedure. So this is a many customer, the most of the customer, the most of the user of the relational database, they like to use the database program. The problem is, so SQL is just kind of the static language. We have very strong structure, select from where. I have a little bit condition, like the in case one, the in case the ID is one, it's a junior. In case ID is two. So I'd like to apply very simple procedural part or condition. So, but I don't want to use the database programming because it's complicated. At that time, is there any way to address one? So database, the company, they think about the something is a stored procedure. Stored procedure, as name implies, is the procedural part, okay? It's like the function that you know, or the class that you are using in your programming. Which side? The DBMS. DBMS side, we can create such a stored procedure. There are two types of stored procedure. One is a function. Another one is a procedure. What is the main difference between the function and procedure? It's the same thing, but function has input and output. Procedure, only input do something. So we can implement such a function inside the DBMS. Procedure inside the DBMS. We already used a built-in function, procedure, before. Count. Do you remember the count? Count. What is a count? It's a function, built-in function. So, for example, I'd like to implement the GPA function. You can do GPA in your program language, but I don't want to use the program language, it's so complicated. At that time, you can create the GPA function using stored procedure. Input is ID. Output is GPA. Inside, using ID, you are able to connect the database, select all the score, then average it, and return the value. Or procedure. Procedure is like the, for example, in case a new user, okay, ID, new user, create the something, add the something, or the delete the something value, then that's it. So you can do the this procedure in the stored procedure. Benefit? It can make the very simple database programming. We don't have to use sometimes the database host language. Okay? And it will be very simple and it can be standardized. GPA, she implemented GPA also. He implemented GPA. So there might be something different. It cannot be synchronized. So we can use the one standardized function. Problem? It looks like the very good to use. So let's say the GPA. So I have the 100, the developer. So they love to use this the function. It's very simple. I can reduce a lot of code. So, but it takes 1 minute to learn this function. Response time is 1 minute. So if all the user use the GPA in the code, it will be slower. So you should make that happen a lot. So for example, in the developing, until the test, so it works very well. Then after launching the system, 10 millions of users select their GPA using the function. Your system will be slow. because it's overhead, so you should care. At that time, you'd better use programming language, host language for such overhead. So, very simple to create a procedure, create a function. You can put something inside the PLC core part. I will quickly show you how to use. Sometimes it's called the PSM. PSM is the name of Infomix. You heard about the PLC core? This is the name of Oracle. And the PSM is the name of Infomix, and so on, which means procedural language, stored procedure are not standardized. Each DBMS has their own syntax. It's not standardized. Okay, so this is an extra slide to a little bit the more details of the database programming. Okay. So keep in mind the database programming needs always the two step. The especially embedded SQL has a pre-compiler and host compiler. So they are grouped by the identified by the such exec SQL begin or exec SQL and begin and end. Okay, these are the example of the C code in Oracle. Okay, so you can see that this part. SQL block should be pre-compiled. And this is a C language to display the error. This is the main part. You can see a lot of the C code. If you already did the C code, C program language, you know the string copy and something length. And this part is SQL part, SQL block, should be pre-compiled. For example, in this case, you get the username. You get the password, then the connect username and password, and create the table, insert the data, and select the data. This is how you can use the C host language based on the embedded SQL. Okay. Cursor, and as I mentioned, there is a gap between the host language and SQL language. Output of the SQL will be group of the data. Such a group of data will be stored at the temporary location in the memory, which is called the cursor. Okay? So you can create your own cursor using the database command. That is open cursor, then fetch and move or do something. Okay? For example, here, the exec SQL. Declare sinfo cursor. This is a temporary space on the memory name sinfo. Then if this cursor is executed, the SQL will be run. Then output of this data will be stored at the somewhere in the memory named sinfo. All group of data will be stored. Then how can we get? First declare and open the cursor. Then you can fetch one by one. You can fetch one by one. Until when? No more data in the room cursor. That is the error. Okay? In case of error, you will up. So that is the embedded approach. Let me quickly skip the embedded part.